feel better when I'm dancing. Yeah, yeah. I'm better when I'm dancing. Yeah, yeah. We can do this together. I bet you feel better when you're dancing. Yeah, yeah.
Good evening, everyone. We are so excited for you to join us and welcome to the Rising Sixth Grade Information Night. So again, we're so thrilled that you could join us. We are doing a webinar format. So you see the panelists on today, and we have over 100, almost 150 folks on right now and more that will be joining us. So again, thank you. My name is Catherine Porter Lucas. I'm the proud principal of Gainesville Middle School for the Arts and Sciences. And tonight you'll have a chance to hear from several staff members about the programs that we offer here at Gainesville. You will see that there is a Q&A option for you to populate questions throughout the night. Our goal is for this to be a 1 hour session or less. And so if time permits, I will address some of the frequently asked questions from the Q&A. If we do not have time, please be on the lookout because the first week of August, I will send out a welcome back letter. And then in August, we will definitely know more about what the fall will look like for us. So I will address any unanswered questions then. And we will also host an open house the week prior to the start of school. So we start school August 23rd. So the week before, we will have an open house, and that will be for all three grade levels. And that will include a tour of the building, information sessions to help parents and students, again, at all three grade levels to be acclimated for the school year 2021. So in the meantime, if you have specific questions pertaining to your child or family that cannot wait until August and need to be addressed prior to that time, please feel free to contact us and we are here to help. So at this time, it is my pleasure to introduce the administrative team at Gainesville. So we have Mrs. Graham, Mrs. Long, and Mr. Miller on today. Go ahead and wave to our admin team, wave and say hello. I know we can't see their lovely faces this evening, but we are so excited to have you coming to Gainesville. So again, tonight, throughout the night, we will have representatives that speak briefly about the offerings at GVMS. And again, we are excited that you are joining our awesome Gainesville community. So at this time, take it away to our counseling team.
Hello, I'm Mrs. Tracy, and I'm one of the counselors here at Gainesville Middle School. I will be working with sixth graders next year, along with Mrs. Pasherdice. And the counseling department is very similar to what your counselors did at the elementary school level. We will work with you on all of your social, emotional, and academic needs. We do individual counseling sessions, small group, and classroom lessons designed on by your grade level. And we're going to help assist you in your transition to middle school. We have five school counselors here at Gainesville Middle School. And again, I will be working with you next year, and so will Mrs. Pasterdice. Mrs. Pasterdice?
Here we are, on to the next slide. Five ways middle school is different than elementary. And yes, middle school is different than elementary school, but it's different in many exciting ways. First off, students will be given a class schedule on student view and on parent view on the first day of school or prior to school, so you can view that. And students will have 7 different classes and 7 different teachers in one school day. During a typical school year, students will be assigned a locker. Also, during a typical school year, students are required to change clothes for PE and will be given another locker in the PE locker room. And finally, students have an opportunity to join many sports teams and clubs that take place after school, and activity buses are provided on Mondays and Thursdays.
Ms. Tracy, still there?
Yes, I'm here. I was going to go over a typical day for a sixth grader. Do you have that slide? Perfect. Okay, so a typical day for a sixth grader. We're going to go over briefly what classes you will be taking. Every sixth grader takes language arts, math, science, social studies, and creative writing. Each sixth grader will also have a music of your choice. You should have received that form. If you did not, feel free to email me and we can get that over to you. Your choices were band, orchestra, or chorus. So you'll have music class that rotates every other day with health and PE. And lastly, students will have one encore class per quarter. These courses are tech ed, art, facts, which is stands for family and consumer science, drama, communication, and or Signet. You will be randomly placed into these encore classes, except of course Signet. Thank you.
All right, so we're gonna back up. We missed two important slides. We have a ton of clubs and activities. So it is very important that you get involved in a club or activity. At Open House, we will have more information about our clubs and activities. And then every September in a typical year, we have a clubs and activities fair. So students will be able to learn about each of the clubs and activities here at GVMS. And we think it is a very important part of being part of Team Gainesville that students get involved. And so look for that information fair in the fall so that you can choose which club and activity you would like to be a part of. Thank you. And there's some of the long list right there. All right.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Amanda Taylor, and I am one of the creative writing teachers here at Gainesville. I'm going to talk to you tonight about the English language arts courses available at school. So all students will be taking language arts and creative writing. Language arts consists of reading, writing, research, and communication skills, studies of fiction, nonfiction, and poetry. Students are exposed to each genre through engaging novels, short stories, and thematic units, and they're able to further develop their skills in descriptive, narrative, expository, reflective, and persuasive writing. In creative writing, students will be mastering their writing, research, and communication skills by participating in highly creative, project-based themed units. They'll be creating fictional and nonfictional stories, poems, children's books, posters, videos, and multimodal presentations. They'll also be designing many projects that coincide with math, science, social studies, language arts, as well as encore classes. For next year, we have a brand new textbook adoption, so that's exciting. Students will be able to have new textbooks. They include high interest themes and reading choices, engaging writing projects, and each student will get their own digital license. GVMS summer reading program is strongly encouraged. It is optional, but we encourage all of our students to read all summer long. The summer reading project is collected the first week of school. Information and documents can be found on the Gainesville Library Canvas page. And on that Canvas page, you will find book recommendations and choice boards with reading project ideas. We're looking forward to seeing everybody next year. Thank you.
Welcome. I'm going to tell you about the four things you need to know about math here at Gainesville Middle School. Number four, your teachers can't wait to have an unforgettable year with you. I am Mrs. Wisniewski, and the other three math teachers are Ms. Bergman, Mrs. Hyatt, and Mrs. Mike. Number three, you will be placed in one of the following three courses. Traditional Math 6, in which students learn all of sixth grade math. Extended Math 6, where students learn all of sixth grade math plus half of seventh grade math. Or Extended Math 7. That's where students skip 1.5 years of math, or Extended Math 6. They learn the second half of seventh grade math and all of the eighth grade math curriculum. Information on your student's placement will be coming. Number two, two things you can do to be prepared for the sixth grade math. First, finish fifth grade math strong, and I know you all will. And second, practice those math facts over the summer. And the number one thing that you should know about our math is we are very excited to see you all in the fall back at school.
Okay, science. I'm Mike Logan. I've taught sixth, seventh, and eighth grade science, and it's a short, it's a great curriculum all 3 years. Sixth and eighth grade are physical science based, and seventh grade is life science based. Now, sixth grade, our focus really is some of those physical science things, such as environment or sciences, little matter, little chemistry, and energy and weather, and our solar system. And seventh grade focus is, of course, living things, classifying, characterizing, and cells, and using the microscopes. In eighth grade, you go a little more in depth into the physical science specifically, and especially chemistry and physics.
All right, hello. My name is Mr. Shipp. I am the social studies department chair at Gainesville Middle School, and I'm an eighth grade teacher. I'm here tonight to represent our sixth grade social studies teachers, Ms. Holland, Mr. Spencer, Mr. Dimitri, and Mrs. Jones. And I'm going to give you a quick rundown of what you can expect from your social studies classes while you're at Gainesville. In middle school, you'll take a different social studies topic each year. As you can see there on the screen, in sixth grade, you'll learn about U.S. history from the early days, the explorers and the early Americans up until the Civil War. Then in seventh grade, you do U.S. history part two, which covers from Reconstruction up till the present day. And then in eighth grade, you'll finish off middle school learning about civics and economics, which is learning about the government of the United States. Now, parents, if you're like me, you remember your history classes in school being probably doing a lot of reading out of the textbook, and once in a while you'd watch a video and write an essay or something like that. Well, and at Gainesville, our teachers work really hard to get the kids engaged in their social studies classes. So they will be doing things like working with primary source materials and historic documents and learning to think like a historian. In a typical year, which we hope to be next year, we do a lot of hands-on activities and simulations, trying to get kids really involved in learning history. We often do, for instance, when they learn about pioneers, our teachers will do a land rush simulation out on the field, and they have to go and stake their claim to their own land. We have trunk programs where docents come from the Marine Corps Museum at Quantico, and they bring an actual trunk full of artifacts that kids can check out. We hope to be able to do those next year. And we also offer a lot of extra activities, like Ms. Porter-Lucas was mentioning earlier, for kids who are really interested in social studies. We have a geography bee, a history bee club. There's a history film club. So I think your students will really enjoy their social studies classes while they're at Gainesville. If you ever have any questions about history, please feel free to contact me. Welcome again to Gainesville.
Hi there. I am Mrs. Albright. I personally have the best job ever. I am one of two art teachers at Gainesville. We both absolutely love art and believe that all kids can create art. Some students think that they can't, but we know that they can, and we will help them to enrich and enhance their art to a higher level. Sixth grade are in art class for every day for 9 weeks. During that time, there's a great amount of exploring different medium, from tempera paint to pastels, colored pencils, watercolor paints, clay, wire sculptures, and we use many of the same materials from elementary school, but with a heightened involvement and understanding. We make connections to science, history, math, and English, and art helps students to increase their critical thinking skills and express themselves and to just plain create. So we make a lot of mess in art class. It's fabulous. This is the best art department at the best school in the county. And we both art teachers love teaching, and we love for making art as well, which shows through our enthusiasm with the subject. It is very evident in our classrooms, and our excitement for trying new lessons is definitely obvious. Thank you so much, and I look forward to making some awesome art with you next year. There is a QR code right there for our county display of art on the website, on the virtual display this year. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Brian Heater, and I'd like to really quickly jump on Miss Albright's bandwagon. I love my job too, so much, in fact, that I retired once and came back to teach again. I team teach with Mr. Powell. We get together in the lab every day, and we actually teach the both classes the same thing. We are very focused on hands-on, brains-on, and we're very cognizant of the OSHA, that's the Occupational Safety and Health Administration's safety features. We teach the kids safety in handling both hand tools and numerous power tools. The sixth and seventh graders in particular will get into power tools right off the bat. We do woodworking projects with both of them. We have also done model rockets, which we're doing right now online. And we have also done power race cars before. We keep the kids very active with hands-on information in the laboratory. And we also are big into the CADD, which is computer assisted drawing and design software. The kids are designing both 3D models on the computer and also 3D models, which can be 3D printed. Mr. Powell does have a 3D printer in his lab. So we will keep your kids interested right off the bat. They will love tech education. Thank you very much.
Hello, I am Jordan Noble. I'm the drama teacher currently. A quick question, is the embedded video gonna work or no? Seems like a no, okay, that's all right. But that is who is taking over next year in drama. Sadly, I'm moving away, but in drama in middle school, what you can expect is for your kids to be, well, should we have a normal year, up, moving around, interacting, learning to express themselves, learning to tell stories, but also learn some about the, thank you for that message. Learn some about the backstage and the technology involved in creating theater as well. So it combines a lot of different disciplines. And I'm sure that Ms. Rodriguez-Snellings will continue that interest in not just the onstage, but also the backstage side of theater as well. Thank you very much.
Hello, I'm Mr. Ballas. I'm the band director at Gainesville Middle School, and I'm representing the music department, which includes band, orchestra, and chorus. And like it was mentioned earlier, if you did not receive a music selection form or get one of those turned in, please make sure you check in with Mrs. Tracy or Ms. Pachardis so that they can get that squared away for you. We have two wonderful chorus teachers. So they are on the screen now. That is Mr. Peters and Miss Melendez, and they are a great team, lots of energy. They work together. When mitigation guidance allows, they'll be combining their classes to sing together and team up. They'll work a lot on reading music and just creating a really fun, exciting music community. And they provide a lot of extra opportunities for their students, like the All-State Chorus event and things like that, as well as our normal winter and spring concerts that we do. So moving on to the next slide here, we have some pictures of the orchestra and band program. So Mr. Persons is our orchestra teacher. And if your student is interested in playing or already plays a string instrument like the violin, viola, cello, or double bass, that would be the spot for them. And they'll also work on reading music, understanding and performing it, and doing a lot of fun tunes together. And for the band, we start all band members from the beginning, so you don't have to have any experience. In fact, I would say 99% of our band students don't have experience yet. If we're able to, we'll let students try out the different instruments at the beginning of the year and see what fits them well, so we can find one that they enjoy doing and seems to work well for them. The instruments that we have available for band are flute, clarinet, saxophone, trumpet, trombone, baritone, tuba, and percussion. And in addition to working on reading music, performing on those instruments, we would do a winter and spring concert as well. So no matter what music class you guys sign up for, your students will have a great time, and we're really looking forward to meeting with you guys. Thank you.
Just as bad as in class. Okay. I'm Karen Rubrecht. I am department chair and founding member of one of the founding members of Gainesville Middle School. So we have two teachers here. Mrs. Schooley is the other facts teacher. And we are part of the CTE department. And if you don't have an older child in the school system, you'll find that that stands for Career and Technical Education. And the three things that set us apart from the regular gen ed classes with that, we do go over workplace readiness skills. And then we develop leadership skills through our embedded professional affiliate, which is FCCLA. And your student would find out more about that when they move on to the high school. And then we identify career connections within our program. Okay, next slide. Okay, so we have seven main areas that we go over. And within the facts field, which is family and consumer sciences, as it was said earlier, in sixth grade, we mainly focus on, it's called personal development, and there are seven different areas. So your child's becoming a preteen, and the first unit that we get into is understanding positive interpersonal relationships as it pertains to their families and their friends. So we get into peer pressure and also, you know, what it means to become a preteen. Then we move seamlessly right into their role within their family, and we delve into the cultural background and celebrate our diversity and share that. We move on to developing responsibility for our living environments. And this has been a big one since the students have been home. We have something called mission organization, and the parents love it because they have to organize their bedroom. So we've been getting on and seeing students cleaning their bedrooms in the background in Zooms and folding their shirts and things and, you know, stuff like that, learning how to do laundry and so forth. Then we move on to textiles, fashion, and apparel concepts. They do learn to hand sew. We're doing that right now so that they can make basic clothing repairs. And you can see a little picture up there. We were wondering how this was going to go over at home, but it went over really well. So you can see that little pillow that student made. Nutrition and wellness is always a favorite. You can see some home baking. Our classroom's going to look a little different than what they're used to. And usually the students love it. And they're kind of amazed at first when they see it because it's a huge classroom. No complaints there. Five kitchens. And then we also have another one with a lab where we get the sewing machines out and we have the babies, because you can see the bottom area that we cover is education and early childhood concepts, because as they turn 12, they're now legally old enough to babysit. So we have some of the computer-aided babies that they get to take care of during class, and they're simulate the different things because we teach them some of the what we call ages and stages, the different things that the babies do from newborn up to age four. To back up, examining consumer and family resources, Prince William County has the sixth grade, the eighth grade, and then once before they graduate, the students have to take a financial planning class and learn that. So you can see some pictures of like the home baking. Normally we'd be doing that. We're doing that since we returned to school. In the middle there was something that they up-purposed for their house. And the bottom right is an example of our interdisciplinary. You know, we do have some math and then there's some food science going on there. So that's what happens when a student puts in a quarter cup of baking powder in cupcakes, muffins, instead of a quarter teaspoon. So anyway, so we have a lot of fun and can't wait to see. Yeah, people are checking it out. Can't wait to see you all. And the student did, as part of their mission organization, clean that up for me, which is very nice. Anyway, so we have a lot of fun and can't wait to see you next year. Thank you.
Next. Hi, I'm Laura Harris. I'm the department chair for health and physical education. You can see our gym, which usually is where we meet for this event, on the screen for you. In the next slide, we're going to talk about the differences between PE and for elementary versus middle school. So in middle school, we actually have 4 to 5 PE teachers. You're going to be randomly assigned to one of those. Usually you only have PE twice in a encore rotation. In middle school, we actually see you every other day. So 1 week we'll see you Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and then the next week we'll see you Tuesday, Thursday. You do change clothes in middle school, so we do have a locker room. You wear appropriate footwear just like you do in elementary school, but we would go into the locker room to change into clothes for hygiene purposes. In the locker room, you're going to rent a lock from us. It's your responsibility to keep track of your belongings. For the grades, they actually are A, B, C, D, F. For middle school, you guys are probably used to the S's and the O's. So it's graded just like a core class. We do fitness testing just like you do in fourth and fifth grade. Another exception, or not exception, but addition to that is we also have end of the unit tests for every topic that we teach in health and also physical education. You'll be improving your skills for games when you're in middle school in preparation to actually play the game in high school. And we do actually have health class. So this is going to be taking place on Canvas next year. Usually we do it during class, but to kind of have more time in PE, we're gonna switch gears and we're gonna do health as homework at home. But we'll explain that more to you guys next year when we see you. And then on the next slide, a teacher will be posting their syllabus on the Canvas page for you all to review all of the different things, important information that you need to know. Look for more information in August with the open house. This is where we do sell the workout gear. So you're able to come in and purchase the shirt, the shorts, the mesh bag. We do offer sweatshirts and sweatpants as well. Information about the locker room. Please do not go out and purchase a lock. You actually have to rent one from us for security purposes. We have to be able to get into the locker if need be. So do not buy your own lock. We will do rentals for that for you guys. And if you ever have any questions, you can feel free to reach out to me and my email address is in the PowerPoint for you. Look forward to seeing you guys.
All right, hello everybody. My name is Mr. Grinnell. I'm the athletic director at Gainesville Middle School. So what that means is that I'm in charge of all the sports and all our teams that we have. And what you're not used to is interscholastic athletics, grade 6 through 8. We have many different teams that we'll see on the next slide, but we're not there yet. But there's two things that every year are the most important things to be able to participate, and they're required from the county. And one of them is a sports physical. This sports physical is different than entrance paperwork that you come into middle school with. It's a specific form. It is on the county website. It's on our school website. It should be readily available for you to find. And that must be dated after May 1st. So anytime now until the sporting season starts, that would be valid. All right. And we keep saying a typical school year. We keep hearing those terms. We're hoping that we are going back to a typical school year, because we haven't had middle school athletics in about a year and a half now. So this is all based on if we are going back to a typical school year. And as of right now, that is the hopes. And then concussion training. Concussion training is the second piece. in order to try out for something, try out for one of our sports. And in the past, sixth graders were required to show up live face-to-face. As of right now, we're not quite sure how it's going to look, but they are leaning towards opening that up to an online training, which you could just print out a completion card and bring that in and hand in along with the sports physical. And if you have those two pieces of, or those two documents, then you hand those in to myself in the gym and they will be able to try out for a sport. And those things last all year long. So if you hand in physical in August, you can try out for a sport in fall, you can try out for a sport in winter, you can try out for a sport in the spring. Next slide, please. Here are our list of middle school sports and when they actually happen in the fall, starting right in the first week of school. Usually the third day of school is football, boys soccer, girls track, volleyball, and cheer. And the winter is broken down into two different sections. In November, we have a winter one season, which is just girls basketball by itself. Then in winter two, we have in January, boys basketball and wrestling. In the spring, starting in late March, baseball, softball, girls soccer, and boys track. All right, so this is a tryout process. And yes, sixth graders do make teams. It can be difficult, but sixth graders do make teams. And then obviously as seventh graders, more will make teams. As eighth graders, they are kind of the, you know, the lead of the school. So they really, many, many make teams as eighth graders. Tryouts are after school. They run 3 or 4 days. And just basically, as again, in the typical school year. So please continue to check our website. We're going to blast out information this summer because we are still in that unsure phase of how things are exactly going to look this fall when that time comes around. So please look for updated information on our web pages and any correspondence with the school. Thank you very much.
I'm one of two gifted teachers. I'm Mr. Keck, and I also work with Mrs. Harmon, and we actually meet with students, and this is different than elementary school, because in elementary school, you meet all year long, but are pulled out of maybe your math class, or your language arts class. Not for us. For us, you actually get a scheduled time during Encore 1 quarter during the year. So you'll have us for an entire 9 weeks, and you get to come in and do all the fun projects that we have. And you don't have to miss your math class or your language arts class to be able to do that, which for some of you is a great thing. If you could, the next one. And so we do lots of projects. If you're identified for language, you'll go with Mrs. Harmon, and she does all kinds of really great language-based activities. They do lots of books, they do some drama, they do some playwriting. And for mine, we do lots of different math activities. We draw and we build and we do all kinds of stuff like that. And all of these are all done while we're working with our peers and working with each other.
Hi, everybody. I'm Megan Hyatt. I'm one of the sixth grade math teachers, and we're going to take a little fun break right now, and we are going to do some trivia. So we are going to see what you know about Gainesville Middle School. So I am launching the poll right now, and you should see that pop up. We have some questions about our mascot, the name of our mascot, our school colors, and what year the school opened. So take your best guess. Maybe you noticed some helpful hints in that picture of the gym. Oh, we have some people that know some things about our school. Awesome. Okay. Get in there and answer those polling questions. It's okay if you're right or wrong. Give it your best guess. Okay, see, about half of our participants have answered. We'll give you about 30 more seconds. Ooh, heated debate on what the mascot's name is going on right now. No, I'm sorry, the panelists cannot answer the questions, only our incoming students. Okay, get those answers in. And I'm going to close the poll in about 15 seconds. Take your best guess, submit your poll. And then we'll see what our results are. Okay, here we go. Poll is ending. Let's go ahead and share the results and see what we know. So our GVMS mascot is a hawk. Perhaps you got a hint from looking at those pictures of our gym. Eagle's a good guess because that's also a bird. And then the name of our mascot, our mascot's name is Mohawk. Our school colors, our school colors are navy blue and light blue. And the school opened, you guys know this well, 2007. Excellent job, incoming sixth graders.
Miss Hyatt, they fooled you. They put navy blue and light blue. What are our school colors?
I thought so. I was like, that was marked wrong. It's green and blue. Okay.
Green and blue.
It is green. I was like, wait, I didn't think that was the school colors, but I was going with what the poll said. Green and blue, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, we have one more fun thing for you this evening, and that is we have a fun opportunity for you to enter to win some GVMS prizes. So right now, I am putting in the chat a link to a form, and you can click on that form. It's going to ask you for your name. Make sure you put your first and your last name, what elementary school you are joining us from, and also in a complete sentence, what you are most excited about next year at Gainesville Middle School. So complete that form, get it submitted, and we will have some winners who will be receiving some fun prizes in the mail. Thank you all so much for joining us tonight. Mr. Spencer, take it away.
Hi, I'm Keith Spencer. I've been a teacher here since 2009, I think. I've been asked to speak on behalf of all of the teachers, the sixth grade teachers here at Gainesville Middle School. I teach social studies, but first off, we are really excited to have you come here next year. But the most important message that we want you guys to understand is we're going to take very good care of you next year. So as soon as the first day of school starts, we're hoping your parents will get you on the right bus. And a tip for parents, if your kid is going to be riding the bus, please, please have them ride the bus the first day. Save that special Chick-fil-A breakfast for the next week. We love for kids to arrive at school the same way they're going to be arriving for the rest of the year. Okay, so kids, you're probably a little bit worried. It's natural to have some butterflies in your tummy. We teachers and your parents are going to have it the first day of school too. But we want you to know we're going to take excellent care of you. From the moment that your bus pulls up, we're going to get you off the bus, make sure that you know your bus number. We're going to get you into your first period. And throughout the day, through all seventh periods, you're not going to get lost. You're not going to get stuffed into a locker. It's all going to be great. You will even get fed while you're at school. It's going to be a wonderful experience. By the end of the day, you're going to take a deep breath and go like, whoo, that was so easy. So we want you to know we care about you. It is going to be a great experience. We can't wait to meet you guys when August comes around. So have a wonderful summer and we'll see you in August.
Welcome to Gainesville!
Hello, I'm Mrs. Prime. I am so glad to be here tonight with all of you. I want to share a little bit about our special education department at Gainesville. We do have three different programs here. We've got the Learning Disabilities Program, an Autism Program, and Intellectual Disabilities Program. And with each of these programs, students receive instruction in the small class or the inclusion general education class or in the general education class totally. Your students will be assigned a case manager shortly when the school year begins, and that special education teacher will become very familiar with your student's file, with their needs, their goals they're working on, and any information that was shared during our transition meetings. That special education case manager will be your point of contact. he or she will share all the information needed to make a successful year with all of your children's teachers. I also wanted to share, since I talked about transition meetings, that we have begun, we're nearly finished with our transition meetings with the elementary school. Our team has been spending a lot of time in Zoom meetings with your schools. So I'm sure I have met several of you already, and I know several other of our teachers have gone to the elementary school. And it's at these transition meetings that we work very hard to make sure that we answer all your questions. We make sure that we take down information that'll make the transition smoother. And we take all that information back to the school to make that school year just as smooth and an easy transition for you. And if by chance you haven't met with Gainesville Middle School staff yet, and your child does have an IEP, please reach out to your elementary school and just let them know that you would like to have that transition meeting. Thank you.
Hi, good evening, everybody. My name's Patrick McGraw, and I'm the department chair for ESOL. In our department, we work specifically with English language development. And this is a program that's specifically designed for students that are beginning their English language skills. We break this down into three basic programs. We have the beginning English learners, and they're instructed in a class where there's only beginning language skills, and they work primarily with our ESOL teachers, myself and Mrs. Patterson. We have our intermediate language learners. They've been here maybe a couple years, maybe a little bit longer, and they work with not only one of us, one of the ESOL teachers, but they also are co-taught in a language arts classroom. So they have the support of two teachers. And then we have our advanced program where these students have either exited or their language skills are highly developed. And they are usually just monitored for a couple of years to make sure that they are doing well and they don't need any additional help. So it's not too different from the way it works at the elementary level, but if you do have any questions, please feel free to contact either the school or myself or Mrs. Patterson. Our emails are over there on the corner, or just let us know at any time. I appreciate it, and look forward to seeing you all in the fall at the back to school. Thanks.
Hello, I'm Christine Ware. I'm the library department chair at Gainesville, and we are looking so forward to meeting our new sixth graders and finding out what you're interested in and what you'd like to read, and hopefully introducing you to your next great read. Our library has over 21,000 books, and we anticipate seeing you on a regular basis for opportunities to check out and also to do fun activities like escape rooms and research and all that good stuff. We have access to several online databases, ebooks. We have a really fun maker corner with things like a Lego wall and Spiro bots and Kiva planks and chess sets and all that good stuff. With me in the library, I have Mrs. Klassen, who's my co-librarian, and also Mrs. Profiter is our library assistant. This summer, we encourage you to just read, 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 keep reading. There is information about the Gainesville Summer Reading Program in two places. It's on our library Canvas, but it's also just on the regular library page on the Gainesville website. So you can get to that very easily. There also is information about the public library summer reading and other good reading ideas there. Something else we're really excited about is that students can now use their school credentials to access ebooks from the public library through Sora. And there's more information about that in both of our library pages as well. Next year, we are looking forward to having you. And our library is going to have a new look. We are getting new carpet and new furniture. So it's going to be a makeover. Each year we have two book fairs, and also Mrs. Klassen and I host or sponsor some different clubs. We have a book club, and we also have Battle of the Books. So those are some other ways to get involved if you enjoy reading. Thanks.
All right, so our nurse, Nurse Smith, was not able to be here tonight, but she wanted to remind parents about medication that needs to be taken during the school day, must be brought in by a parent or guardian. So please, if you have any questions about medication or you would like to touch base with Nurse Pam Smith, you can email her, smithps@pwcs.edu.
Hi, I'm Tracy Houchins. I'm the president of the Gainesville Middle School PTO. Our board has been voted in with Trish Neal being our vice president, Tanya Beal being our secretary, and Krista Doxy, our member at large. The PTO works alongside the administrators at Gainesville Middle, and we help to raise funds and support the school and whatever they need or require, or what the staff, students, and administrations need throughout the year. Next slide. There is a lot of things that we have planned for next year. We have bingo nights, we sell spiritware, we have fundraisers, we provide funds for micro grants to staff. So things that they need in the classroom, we try to help them with. We're planning an online auction. We do the eighth grade Golden Hawk celebration. We do a lot of staff appreciation, holiday in the halls, Valentine's for teachers. We also just kind of try to be around and help out with things. This past year, over the last 3 years, we have been able to raise a lot of funds and do a lot of great things. And this past year, we were able to purchase a scoreboard for our athletics. So we do a lot of great things. We always could use a little bit of help. If you're interested in helping with us, helping us with one of the committees or events, we'd love to have you. We do need a treasurer, so this is the only plug you're going to get for that. But just becoming a part of the PTO is really a great way to stay in touch with what is happening at the school, what's going on, and what your child can expect. So please consider joining us. Thank you. Oh, and also we have our final PTO meeting Tuesday night via Zoom. I'm going to go ahead and put in the Q&A. The link for that, but if you want to go ahead and email us at the PTO email that's listed there, we can go ahead and send you the credentials, but it's a great way to get started at Gainesville Middle. Thank you.
Hello, sixth graders. My name is Mary Kate Graham. I am one of the assistant principals at Gainesville. And I just want to welcome you to the Hawk family. We're so excited that you guys get to join us next year. So I want to kind of go over some of the expectations of our Hawks. So we always hope for the best with academic success. We have lots of supports in place. You have wonderful teachers that you'll have next year that are there to help you out and help you shoot for the stars. We have a positive behavior program at school called SCORE, which is success through courtesy, organization, respect, and excellence. So that is something that we are really excited about. And I have to say, I missed a part of my slide. Our motto, which I'm going to say it once, and you're going to hear it every day that you're in middle school for 3 years. And I don't want to steal her thunder, but I'm going to. It's courtesy and respect for all today, for that is the Gainesville way. So courtesy and respect, those are our two houses that we have right now at school. And it's really our belief system. So I'm going to kind of go back to SCORE. So that positive behavior program that we love, and it's actually kind of become really cool. So we have a badge program. So I have my, it kind of looks like you get this badge when you get at the end of first quarter, and it's based on your grades, your effort, your conduct in class. And it's really cool. And when you get one of those badges, it's gold, silver, or bronze. You get some pretty cool perks. We have, sometimes you get to leave on the first bell at the end of the day. We usually have a couple bells. You get quarterly treats. Sometimes you get free admission to those athletic events or drama events, like plays, the musical. We have lots of great things. And in years past, we've done bring your own device on Friday, where you could play your game on your cell phone or another device, and or listen to some music. We do that in the cafeteria. So we'll do some different things, some treats and rewards for, you know, you working so hard in middle school. Listen, we are so excited that we get to see you every day next year, and welcome to Gainesville.
Good evening. My name is Tyler Francis, an eighth grader at Gainesville Middle School, and I'm here to show you some successful tips to have a good time at Gainesville Middle School. Tip number one, get organized. In order to be successful, you should use your agenda to comply with deadlines and other information the teacher may provide. Tip number two, if you need help, ask. Teachers are here to help you. If you ever need clarification on any assignment, ask. Tip number three, get involved. Gainesville offers many clubs from different areas, from building robots with Robotics Club to acting with Drama Club. I've enjoyed my time at Gainesville Middle School, and you will too. Welcome to Gainesville, School for the Arts and Sciences. Good evening, my name is Tyler Francis, an eighth grader.
So we know that was a lot of information tonight. We just wanted to highlight our programs. Gainesville Middle School for the Arts and Sciences is such a wonderful place for students to be. We try to create a positive environment for all students, all staff, our families. And so again, this event was recorded. So if you missed any of the information, or if you wanna just watch it again because it was so exciting, it will be posted on our website. Again, we thank you so much for joining us. We tried to address some of the Q&A questions and the information that was in the chat. Again, if you need immediate assistance, please reach out to the school. We are here. If you have any questions or concerns, you can send an email or call us. Again, remember, a lot of our information will be shared the first week of August when you receive the welcome letter, as well as when we host that August open house event the week before school starts. Before we end, I do want to remind you students to complete that exit ticket so that you can have a chance to win a prize that we will mail to you. It's just your first name, last name, elementary school, and something that you're excited about for next year. So again, we hope that you have a great evening. Students, enjoy the rest of fifth grade because soon you will be a Gainesville High Flying Hawks. Good night. So high, I touched the clouds. Whoa, oh.